Thank you for tuning in to another episode of 420 Grams. Now, the focus of our attention on this show was the recently concluded Indian Women's League that took place in Ludhiana, and Sethu FC walked away as the winners of the second edition of the Indian Women's League.
Third edition.
Perfect start to the show. But of course, I'm joined on the show by two people who were there and watched it from an arm's distance, Siddhant, Annie and Aditi. And also to talk about just the women's game and where it is right now, we've got seasoned journalist Sharda Ugra standing under a tree because that is next level dedication. Sharda, respect.
Hi. It's great to be here. It's very hot. My sacrifices for Indian football are enormous.
So I'm going to start Sethu FC first and foremost. Deserved winners for you guys. Was that the best team on show?
I think maybe Aditi should take the question because she was actually covering it from the perspective of a reporter. I was just generally hanging around checking out the scene. But there were many teams, I think, that were up to a decent standard, no?
Yeah, Manipur for one. And which were also the finalists with Sethu.
Baladevi.
Yes. And then there was
Gokulam,
SSB. These are all teams and players from teams that we spoke to. And they were quite good.
So what was the sense that you got from them? And you were talking to these guys and, you know, you were talking to them about stuff around football. And, you know, because when you're talking about women's football, it's still not as evolved as the men's game right now.
So what was the kind of sense you got from them?
So if you can call the men's game evolved.
Whatever level it is, evolved at.
So I think the two major kinds of teams that we spoke with were, one set of teams were teams whose players, and I mean these teams didn't get any funding, and their players came from community programs. And then the other teams were, for example, Manipur we didn't get a chance to speak with, but we watched them play closely. And then there was SSB, there was Gokulam, Kolhapur, Sethu. All these teams had players who were national players, 6 to 7 each, in fact. And so the general sense was that as a league, I mean, you can't really compare all the teams. Pit them against each other because the level of playing then obviously was very different.
So I think the system that they figured out to, for what it's worth, make it balanced, is that they asked the state federations to have state leagues for women. So only those states would be eligible to play in the women's league
that
have conducted state leagues. So to have some kind of a starting point.
ये नहीं कि मतलब team बना के पहुँच गया.
आप पहुँच गए. हाँ. तो as a consequence of that, like she's saying, the range of teams or their quality and whether they are semi-pro or absolutely amateur is different. Clubs like Gokulam, which have an existing structure and an understanding of football clubs, perhaps a little bit more money, they have made a sort of, they've given contracts to their players and tried to build a team that has all the paraphernalia, at least, of a professional squad, including sort of video analysis and a media manager and, you know, all these little bits and bobs. So, and while the others like Bangalore United, who in fact is being coached by a lady called Chitra, who's one of the oldest, like she played the first women's international that India ever played.
First ever.
In 1975, yeah.
Respect.
Huh. And she's been involved with this sport, so massive amount of experience she has and an extremely sort of interesting lady to talk to because she must be, what, in her mid-50s now? Or actually older probably. And but she's constantly updating herself, doing the latest badges, coaching badges, doing grassroots programs, whatever she can to learn and learn ways of, I suppose, imparting the knowledge of the game to as many people as she can.
So, Sharda, you know, you've been covering sports for a long time. And just the fact that the conversation around the women's game has moved beyond ki mujhe khelne ko nahi milta, mujhe society mein khelne ko nahi milta, to the fact ki ab kya game mein ho raha hai, what the game is all about. Do you suppose that in itself is, you know, suggesting progression for the women's game?
Absolutely. So I am just thinking about what he's talking and I've been following sort of the stories of a few of the women footballers who came on your program, and then you're looking at the reports that were coming in wherever they were, in whatever scattered form they were from the media. And it's just a relief to find that there is something there, you know, and that it is there. And the moment it increases, sort of it will start gathering pace. What I had wanted to ask Aditi, for example, is what did she find with the physical level of the players that were there? Because they are seeing women playing football at another level. The World Cup, Women's World Cup is this year. What did you find there in terms of their physical capability? Never mind what the technical skills are. What was the physical sort of the level over there? It would have been uneven, I'm assuming. And I want to know how the Bangalore team did, because there was a Bangalore team.
This is what we were talking about in terms of the community program. So when we spoke to, for example, Amulya, now she's a 34-year-old mother of one, and she's actually captain, and she's also coach there back home. And then there's Paramita, Sit. And these are women who are much older in age, but if you're talking about physical capabilities, they seemed fit, and their stamina and the running, I mean...
Are those sort of women's... what was it like to sort of watch women playing football at that length? You know, a few days ago, there was an incredible video about women's rugby that turned up, which was like, wow. And it would be good to see this kind of, you know, to see how women's football is represented even in the public sphere, as in what it's made to be. I mean, I'm thinking about it that when did like Beckham came like years ago? Because I think I'm more than 10 years ago, 15 years ago. You know, so there has to be a Bendit like Beckham moment. I'm not sure whether that is what will take it forward. Because football is a big sport. I'm standing in Bombay where I've just been moved from under the tree to where something is being cleaned by a slightly inebriated gentleman. And I just watched these football matches being played on a rooftop cricket, on a rooftop football ground, full football-sized ground. Till about 2-3 in the morning, got up in the morning at 6 o'clock and the games are still on. So football is there, you know, it's... So how do you pick up this sort of mania that there is women now? How do you pick it up and you move on with it? How does it women's football become part of the cultural conversation like, say, badminton is? You know, or even wrestling or boxing or whatever. That's what I'm interested in. I find the news of the women's league really... something that's just heartening, and you want it to continue. You want it to continue and be regular, not just at a casual level. Because it's had a bit of up and down.
I think because of several factors coming together, and the fact that, for one, FIFA gives a lot of development money for the women's game all over. So conducting the leagues, at least at a showpiece kind of national level, it's pretty much a mandate now. They have to do it. So it's unlikely to disappear. But in terms of the organize, how do you think, or what you spoke to a lot of players, what was the sort of sense that they gave you in terms of how it was organized, put together and scheduled?
So there were majorly two things that I think came up. One was that, I mean, obviously a lot of women, I think most of them whom we asked about organization spoke about how it was off season. And it was extremely hot and they had to play all day in that heat. There were a few days where the weather was... okayish, but other than that,
35?
Okay is 35.
Yeah. Yes. There's a lot of other, so even though a lot of people spoke about how AIFF is, I mean, this is the third league, and they've become better in terms of organization in general. But there were a lot of things that the women did not agree with. One is that this is exam time. So a lot of women who were good and who wanted to come and participate couldn't because they're back home giving exams. Women who got out of the league sooner. So for example, you have Panjim. These are women, some of whom have to go back home and the next day is their economics paper, for example.
You know, I'm just taking cue from what Sharda was saying earlier, ki how can we cultivate a culture?
Yeah.
I think wo culture wala Indian Women's League, thoda usme time hai. I think that culture can be cultivated through the success of the national team. And if the national team starts building on what they've done, then you know that culture will slowly and the conversation around it will happen. Like the same way in cricket, man. In women's cricket, how they started performing an international level. They were amongst the best in the world. Now they are amongst one of the best in the world. And so the same way, like we were having that conversation yesterday, yeah? So if there is a team which can really go and reach the World Cup, an Indian team, it's the women's team, not the men's team. And the way they're progressing right now, what is it, 44?
63.
I was way off. 63 se agar top 20 mein aa gaye, which is not...
You were way off, but the exit polls were not.
But 63 se to come to 20 in the women's game, I know it's... Sharda has now moved into a car.
Yeah.
This is going to be the most incredible sort of recording that I've done of this
one of its kind.
This is sort of journalism on the move, you know, full grassroots... commitment to football. No, what you're saying about the fact that it's a women's team that is going to give you more than the men's team. I mean, 300,000 times that is very obviously going to happen. So women's sports are always, you get first mover advantage if you're smart enough. We have lost first mover advantage over football about, I think, 25, 30 years ago. You know, so, but whatever we've got, what Aditi was talking about, you know, the league, it was held like, in the off season, there were exams. This is almost like a very slipshod way of handling. Achha, humko karni hai, so chalo, let us do it like this, that we'll do it at this time. Ho jaega, ho jaega. You know, these women will come and play. It's okay. No, so you're not showing genuine, serious commitment to calendar and slotting this incorrect, properly, at a proper time. So it might just sound like grumbling, you know, but you have to have some, take care, I think this is the third league in 4 years or 5 years, I think you'll correct me. It's not been consistent enough. It's not happened enough. And the, now what are you going to do with the women that are not going to play in the over 17 women? Ke saath aap kya karna? What is that schedule and calendar going to be like? You know, why didn't you make Larima Shipper's goal go viral by yourself on social media all the time? Put her out, send her to TV studios, you know, all those kind of things. That's what you need to kind of kick on and do.
I don't know. I'm again, like, not taking any sides in this, but from an organizational standpoint, it's very difficult for anyone to sit in Delhi, let's say, and make a structure and say, this is how we want the league to be, simply because we don't know how many clubs will have the wherewithal, the players, the money to even show up to this tournament. Now, so it is, there's a lot of ad hocism and a lot of the organization is just because karna to hai. But the starting point is that only. Ki at least karna to shuru kiya hai.
Kuch to kiya hai. At least something.
No, that's true.
And
that's true.
That's one. That's, and I just cannot... one more thing to come back to what you were saying about the physicality and maybe a little bit about the technical aspects also of the game. The improvement over the past three seasons in this league has been tremendous. And forget about that. Even if you look at how some of the better teams played their first match of the tournament and how they played maybe six matches into the tournament, because simply because all these players had then been together, they'd practiced together, they gotten to know each other,
example.
The communication was better, and therefore they were playing, this level of play also went up as the tournament went along.
So is it that we are getting a bit grumpy and we want more progress and we want more sort of speed of success? I mean, is it that for people like for my generation, say, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up, kya karega, you know? Is it that, or we just need to be a little bit more patient? Because I was very happy and surprised to see 14 teams. You know, next year, I hope it will not be 8. I hope it will at least be 10, you know? So are we just being impatient, or what is the...
I think the progression will continue, because whatever conversations we've had with people in the AIF, whether it be Abhishek Yadav, who's directly involved in, you know, making the schedule of the women's league and the international and the, of course, the national teams and everything. And it is a major part of their plan. And I have a feeling, and yesterday we had the, I would say, privilege of attending the press conference of the coach and the technical director. And for me, that technical director came across as someone really sound. Someone who knows what he's talking about. Of course, that is just a press conference and that was day 4 into his job. What his job will actually entail him to do and how he will really conduct that job after 5 months, wo baad ki baat hai. But so far the signs are there.
Yeah.
Theek hai. Anything else that you came across in the women's league through your conversations with the players and everything? What's the financial situation like? Are they being paid?
No.
Can I just jump in? What was the crowd like? Was it a decent crowd or was it less? I mean, also
six people, two were sitting.
It's incredible actually, because even the autos that we would take to the stadium, even around the people around the stadium, the auto guys who would drop us to the stadium, they're mostly local guys. I mean, I would see the same guy almost every day. They didn't know there's something like this going on inside. No one did.
You know, and the thing is, football is a sport that is taught at so many women's schools. So many girls' schools play football. You know, my niece started playing football in a school in Bombay. So you said school children bhar do, with school, okay, just do something to at least make the girls feel like the Dalima Chipper goal in that event in Nepal. The crowd was, it was full. The ground was packed. You know, so we're not saying, don't pack the ground. But I think along with the, whatever they do about the women's game, you need to fill in all these other little gaps, you know.
But how will that happen, Sharda? I mean, aapne Ludhiana mein karwa diya hai wahan pe.
यार पंजाब में तो देखते हैं लोग यार पीपल वॉच ऑल स्पोर्ट्स यार
नहीं यार इतना मतलब आपने किया
लुधियाना में
आई अंडरस्टैंड यू पिक लुधियाना एज अ वेन्यू बट द ओनली थिंग इज यू हैव टू लिटरली देन ट्राई एंड वर्क बैकवर्ड्स एंड से ओके नाउ वेयर कैन वी प्ले दिस वेयर पीपल विल कम एंड वॉच
या
छोटा
ग्राउंड इन स्टेडियम में करने की क्या जरूरत है अगर स्कूल में लोग आएंगे देखने या स्कूल में लेट्स से देयर आर 1000 पीपल्स इन दैट स्कूल यू हैव अ रेडीमेड कैप्टिव ऑडियंस Have it in a school, yeah? What is the... Why have it in a 20,000-seater stadium?
Then you know the way the press
have
that means...
Have it in a smaller
ground. Jaise usko likhenge na? Ki aapne matlab, you're making the best players in the country play inside a school.
अगर आपका पिच ठीक है और कुछ लोग आ रहे हैं देखने तो कौन कंप्लेन करेगा?
तो आ जाएगी ना सर स्कूल आपने इस्तेमाल किया फॉर दालिमा छब्बर who's just scored for India versus Nepal. You're making a plane.
Yeah, okay, that's like an unfair headline. It will all give unfair headline. Full, I will take full blame for that. But you need to give the women an audience. You need to give every athlete an audience. It's just that I think whatever is being done towards making women's football work, whichever way, like you're talking about the technical director, Abhishek Yadav, how trying to work the calendar. Maybe this other stuff also has to get filled in a little bit, you know. Think of it as like the social media side of women's football that you need to get sort of literally filled in and create these little personalities and characters and do something around it because there is an interest and it doesn't cost money. And venues are very important. Like cricket is having a problem filling ground for test matches. So they're trying to say, let's move to boutique smaller venues. And imagine a sport like cricket where infrastructure is such a hassle and such a and you're able to create some 30 grounds or whatever. So the spin-offs from success of a sport are huge.
Since you brought up the money angle, is the money angle like? Are
only Gokulam was the only club from either the ISL or the I-League that had a team.
No, so just are they being paid for this 4-week window? Are they being paid for the 1 month before that?
No, this is something that I was reading otherwise also, that a lot of people, one main criticism is that you need to make it longer. So that even the national players and whoever is getting paid at all, their contracts then can be extended and they can be paid for a longer time.
So you're saying there were players who are not being paid?
Yeah.
Not at all. So, I mean, most of the teams actually, they weren't being paid at all. And most of the teams that we spoke to, like I'm talking about teams, for example, there's Bangalore, there's Baroda, there's Panjim.
Academy kids, yeah.
These are teams that just, they're just there. Baroda, for example, I think their academy is getting funds, but for them to come play here, there is nothing at all. There are a lot of women who are, a lot of them don't have jobs at all. I mean, there are only a few states, for example, there's Orissa and there's Manipur, where you also have a lot of state backing. So these women who get into football, then that they have that incentive. But for most women who get into football, you don't have an incentive at all. So when you talk about the culture for football growing, that is also something that I think you need to consider.
So what's the motivation then? As a sense, like, paise bhi nahi mil rahe, job bhi nahi mil raha. So motivation kya? You said there was a 34-year-old mother.
Yeah,
what was her motivation? To come and play.
Her motivation is that
love
now she's
game.
I mean, actually, it's extremely sad because at the end of the day, I mean, however much you love a game, it's still, I mean, like it is for men, it still needs to get you some sort of money in.
Yeah, I agree.
I mean, you need to run a home. But that's not what happens in women's football, at least not that I've seen, at least for the 4 days or whatever we're there for a 6-week match, tournament league. And which is really sad. So most of these women who are coming from teams, so for example, Delhi ki team hai Hans, that went through Keto. Keto is an online funding.
Crowdfunding.
Not bad,
yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Well done to Delhi for once.
Only that's about it. All their funds went into going to Ludhiana and staying there, etc., etc. Apart from that, they're not getting a penny.
Well, fair enough. At least that's a step ahead.
Start.
That's a start. You know, how you can bring in some income or the other. Huh? But
so like Gokulam, for example,
biggest players.
No, so the issue with Gokulam or the criticism leveled against Gokulam before the tournament, when the tournament began, was that they didn't have a single Kerala player in their roster.
Okay.
So then the owner of the club as well as the coach explained the situation to us in some length, basically saying that the sports quota jobs in Kerala are taken by basketball, volleyball, athletics, etc. Right? Football, women, there are no jobs. So, therefore, there's no incentive for women. Yeah. They would rather become nurses or school teachers or whatever else they're doing, whatever
other play other sports.
Other sports to khel hi rahe hai na.
There's a fencing academy in Kerala. Fencing. Like, it's Sports Authority of India has a fencing, like a school there where a fencer comes from. So I'm thinking, like, you know, that in terms of the investment into per athlete, and you do a mathematical calculation of the space of the ground and how many people can occupy it and all, football is a no-brainer. But I must be optimism is required at a time like this. I feel. I know I'm not, I shouldn't be, but Arjun is saying, like, you have to, like, optimism nahi karoge, then you'll just collapse and say, okay, nothing's going to happen.
No. And then slowly, slowly, you need to build on it. I agree with you. Now the started, you have to build on it. Yani ki ab 2 saal tak league nahi hua ya jo
my impatience
hua.
Comes from my generation saying ke, boss, we have been liberalized 25 years ago. Come on, there is money. There is money to be given. There is money to be made. Energize, do something. Show, you know, that is where my impatience comes from. I understand your point of view.
If your generation is impatient, Sharda, can you imagine what the kids these days must be like? This is why I think the rate of change has been accelerated, because as impatient as we are, we also sort of have less of a stake in it now, I think, to some extent. And these women who are, whether it's young reporters who are starting out to do stuff or players, they have much more sort of to invest or to gain or lose or whichever way it is from how the system.
Those women are outstanding. The women who play, they are, you cannot even imagine how they are able to do this. It is beyond my comprehension how they are able to do this.
Yeah, and no, and purely from a game perspective also. I mean, you can hate me all you want. पहले जो थोड़े बहुत matches देखे थे, it didn't feel like कि football हो रही है. मैं क्यों देखूं? Right? So that is why all the chatter was around issues, society, and so on and so forth. But ab is season, I'll tell you, I've seen 2 matches though. But 2 matches mein pata chal gaya hai ki the game is so much better. The ball is being kept on the ground. They're moving it around nicely. And then the final, it was like the way Sethu had a plan. That was good to watch, man. The plan worked and they got them on that.
Yeah. Even Pandit was watching it, means.
I was watching it as well, yeah.
So I think 1,500 people were watching online, so it's the final. Yeah.
Also, one more thing, marketability factor. I feel women athletes, it is so much easier to market women athletes as opposed to male athletes, because the general male athlete is a dumb guy. He can't speak. They don't know how to speak. And these guys have put up a story right now on Newsclick where they've done interviews with all these female athletes who are playing at the Indian Women's League. And you can make out just how well, how articulate they are, and the point they want to make and what they're saying is so clear and crisp, you know. So that is something the AIFF should jump on, man. That day Dalima and Aditi were here, they spoke so well. Humne baat nahi kari.
Humne
seekhna chahiye. Baat hi kare ja rahe the, yaar. You know. So that's that. Anyone else has?
So it was interesting. 2 things that were interesting. One was that a couple of senior players actually said that the Ludhiana tournament was better than the one in Shillong.
Which is the first one?
Yeah. No, the last one. Last one was wrong on every count.
Anything, yeah.
Edit. So, which is surprising, because Northeast, at least crowds are guaranteed. There's interest is guaranteed. But they were talking from a, I guess, logistics and organization point of view. So things are getting a little bit better. The other thing was when we did our last round, when they did their last round of interviews, the players were extremely reluctant to come and have a chat.
Why?
Because all the conversations everyone was asking them about was which uncle, brother, father inspired you to play football.
How did you start playing? What's the inspiration? The struggles.
They were like, basically, ye sab hame nahi karna hai, hame rehne do.
That's progression, yaar. Yeah. Skip, chodo ab yaar. Ab baat ho rahi hai football
ki.
So
the minute we said football ke baare baat karenge, fir they're all up for it.
Theek hai. Last comment. I think we've gone way over time. Sharda, you just paid $90 for the toll, so we'll start with you.
Not me. I'm very kindly been. My friends are dropping me to the airport. I'm just going back to Bangalore. So, but it's been fun. It's been fun. Thank you.
Thank you so much for joining.
This was like next level reporting on the move.
Thank Thank you.
And Aditi, any final words from your experience in Ludhiana and everything?
Yes. So this was my first time reporting football, women's football. I was very lucky to do that. I think it's, there's a lot of scope for these women. Most of the women we spoke to, there's a lot of stories that come up that really people need to hear about. There's so much that needs to be said about the game, about the technicalities, and then about why these women, like Sharda was saying, I mean, why are you even doing this when there is no backing, like there is no backing, financial backing, etc. And then when you come and say that men don't speak and women do, I think it's also because they have a lot to say. I mean, in terms of just being able
to... No, I think it's a dumb factor, to be honest. I think the men are just purely dumb. We don't know how to speak. I mean, we learn as we move along.
So there's just, yeah, I mean, it was great.
It was great. Yeah. Perfect. And bhai?
Agree. I mean,
you,
they
you
definitely...
You guys have done a couple of stories, right? So can you tell us what stories you'll be putting out on Newsclick, which people can watch?
Yes. So we did a story a few days back. I think the day of the the day after the final is when it got released. It's called Football on the Margins. So this is when we spoke to Baroda, Bangalore and Panjim. Spoke to them about how they reached Ludhiana in the first place, how they reached the IWL and where they come from, what's the backing in terms of the state that they come from. Is it a state that has a culture of football like Goa does, but mostly just for men and not for women as much. And so I think...
And look forward to any more stories coming up?
This one. I think we're coming up with another... features.
Something on Setu.
Something on Setu, huh? Not bad, bro. Okay, Aditi, Sidhan, thank you so much for joining us. Thanks. Guys, as promised, I don't know, this is the camera. So, as promised, one weekly episode on Indian football. Keep tuning in to 420 Grams on Newsclick.
Coming to you from Thailand next at the King's Cup.
That sounds damn weird, huh?